Hi, and welcome back to MyExcelOnline.com. Today, we are going to go over part three of our data series, which is how to keep a link alive in Excel. Last week, we went over various ways to import data from a source, whether it is another Excel workbook or a source outside of Excel, such as an Access database or a text file. What I would like to show you today is how do you keep that link alive? What happens when the source data changes? Is there a way to see that change inside of Excel? And the answer is yes. We're going to show you how to change the source data and add a new record and see those changes reflected in Excel. We're going to go over what data connections are and where you can find them in your spreadsheet. We'll cover some of the refresh options and also what happens when you change the structure of an underlying data table source. This is last week's spreadsheet where we imported data from various sources such as Excel, text files, and Microsoft Access. But there's more going on behind the scenes than what we led on last week. Every time we imported data from an external source, Excel created a table, and these tables are objects that can be used in Excel that can actually be linked every time the source data has changed. Let me show you an example. Here's my Access database as a data source. What if I went in here and instead of Jim selling 1,000 units, he sold 5,000? I'm going to save that data, exit out of Access, go over here to my Access tab, and I will see right here, it looks like Jim sold 1,000, even though you just saw me update that number in Microsoft Access to 5,000. However, if I go over here to this refresh button on the data ribbon and I go down to refresh, you will see that the number for Jim has been updated to the 5,000 that I had just put into the Access database. This is how I want a live data link to work. If I change the source, I want to be able to change the data inside Excel. If I came in here and I started changing all of my data, and later on I realized I don't really want to change all of my data, I want the original source back, I could simply go down to this down arrow here and hit refresh. And you will see that my numbers will now change back to what they originally were. So I showed you what could happen in Microsoft Access when you edited some information. But what if I went back to Access and I entered a whole new record here for 710, and this was for Jim, and he made a sale in Pennsylvania, and he sold 150 items for $750. It cost him $250, so he made a $500 profit. If I go back to Excel and I click on my From Access tab, watch down here. I'm going to click here and hit refresh, and you will see that that new record has been added. So not only do changes get reflected when you hit refresh all, but also new records that have been added also get updated as well. So how does all of that work? Well, inside my spreadsheet here, I have something called a data connection. Last week when I imported all of that data, I made 5 different data connections. So if I were to go over here to get data and go down here to data source settings, you will see all of the connections that I made last week. The first one is the XML one. The second one is the Access database. The next two are the CSV and the TXT file. And the final one is the other Excel workbook that we were connecting to. Now I can edit these sources. I can change where the file is. Like sometimes you might move the file on your network and then that file no longer exists to link to your Excel spreadsheet. So in here, you could click on change source and browse for that file to where it was moved, and you could reselect that file right here. So these are all the connections that exist inside the workbook that we created last week. So once you have a connection, you also have an object inside of that connection that we're linking to. So if sometimes that object can be a table inside of an Access database, or it can be a tab inside of an Excel workbook. So if I were to go up to this refresh all button and go down to connection properties, notice that I'm on my Access tab. When I want to refresh the data from my original sources, I can go up here. If I hit refresh all, this is going to refresh every connection that I have. And as I just talked about, we have 5 connections going on in this workbook. But if I only want to refresh one file, say from the CSV file, I could go down here and I could just hit refresh and that will refresh my data. Or I can hit refresh all and this will refresh all 5 tabs of my data. If you are liking this video, please give us a thumbs up and subscribe to get notifications of our new weekly Excel tips. But there's also different refreshing options. If I go down here and go to connection properties, I have some control over how I can refresh this workbook. I can do it manually like I just showed you. I could refresh within a time interval right here. I could go anywhere from 1 minute to 100 minutes or even more than that. I can refresh automatically when I'm opening the file. And so those are some of the options that you can use there. But here's another tab that's really helpful. If you click on the Used In tab, you can see everywhere that the CSV will be used. In our case, we only have one tab that it's used on, but sometimes you might be using a data source from somewhere else that's used on multiple tabs. So when you use this Used In tab right here, you will see everywhere in your workbook that that data source is being used. But let's look at my CSV file for a minute. Over here, I created a whole new column called Expenses. Unfortunately, once the table structure has changed, you kind of have to start from scratch. So what I'm going to do is highlight columns A through G, right-click, and go to Delete. And then I'm just going to start my import process all over again. I'm going to go to Data, but this time I'm going to go up here to Recent Sources, and I'm going to select Sales.csv and hit Connect. I can see that the Expenses column is coming in, which is good. I'm going to click here and go to Load To. And I want this to go to the existing worksheet on A1 and say OK. This time I can see right here that the expenses column has come in, which is good. That's what I wanted it to do. I wanted to go over one other option with you on the data tab. If I go here to connection properties, there's this option right here, refresh this connection on refresh all. If I wanted to hit refresh all, but there was just one connection I did not want to refresh, I could take this check mark off and say OK. So now when I hit refresh all, every tab will update except for the from CSV. If I go over to from access and hit the down arrow, look at connection properties, you will see that this connection will be refreshed when I hit refresh all. But if I go back to CSV, hit this down arrow, go back to my connection properties, you can see that this one will not be refreshed when I hit refresh all. But if I check that back on and click the refresh all button, all of my tabs will be refreshed. Remember that data updates only go one way. They go from the source to Excel. If you want to be able to update your data in Excel, you will have to look at the other applications that are linked to Excel and do the update from that application that is doing the linking to Excel. So just remember, it's kind of a one-way street. The source gets updated, Excel reflects that update. It doesn't go the other way around. I can't make a change here in Excel and then have that change sent back to the other data sources. So in review today, we showed you how to change source data or add a new record. We went over the different connections that you can use inside of a linked spreadsheet. We went over some of the refresh options, and then we talked about table structural changes and how to get those into your Excel spreadsheet. And don't forget that updating your data in a linked Excel spreadsheet is a one-way operation. Next week, we are going to go over how to use some of the basic querying options once you have a table inside of Excel. So hopefully you'll join us for part 4 and our final part of our data series session. Hopefully you've learned something new today and look forward to seeing you again next time.
If you like this video, subscribe to our YouTube channel. And if you're really serious about advancing your Microsoft Excel skills so you can stand out from the crowd and get the jobs, promotions and pay rises that you deserve, then click up here and join our Academy online course today.